Hello mates, Tutoramon here. In this video I'm going to benchmark Titanfall 2 on a single GTX 1070 paired with a Core i5-8600K. The recording is done on an external recorder at 60 frames per second, so what you will see in this video will be pure performance. The CPU is overclocked at 5 GHz for benchmarking reasons, not that it needs to. 16 GB of memory, and the graphics card is a GTX 1070 made by KFA 2. It is the EX model, latest Nvidia driver, and also a little overclocked in order to boost at 2 GHz. Now I'm going to use Fraps to collect frame rate data. We will see the basic result in this file and some analysis with Flat at the end of the video. So let's launch the game and let's see what's going on. Settings first, 1080p resolution, no vertical sync. The only thing I'm not using here is the adaptive super sampling, which is, a crazy setting if you want to destroy the performance. Other than that, insane texture streaming budget and everything else maxed out, enabled very high, very far, high. These do not have higher values, only high. Okay. Yes, I did not change anything. However, let me go to my mission. I'm going to use the easy difficulty because, you know, it is a benchmark. It's better to not lose while benchmarking. And I'm not going to benchmark the game right from the beginning, only when the mission starts. However, I'm seeing 144 frames per second stuck there on the MSI Afterburner and Fraps, and I think we are looking at a frame rate cap, which I did not notice before on my other systems, 7950 and 70. That's why I want to be to start my benchmarking from my high-end system first, but sometimes it's just not possible. In any case, we will see how it goes, because I see the new load going a little up. Yes, thankfully it has gone to 99%. It was just an easy scene. Stabilize. I will start the benchmark once the door blows out.
Caution, temporary side effects, nausea, dizziness, impaired motor coordination.
Okay, I'm starting the benchmark.
We got more IMC structures coming to the door! Are we near the top zone?
Very nice. We avoided the frame rate cap. I'm very happy.
Fighting!
Captain Lastimosa. I got a fix on your location. On my way.
You're in bad shape. Hold on. This might knock you out, but you should be okay when you wake up.
Lastimosa, hostile Titans inbound. Apex Predators.
Copy that, BT. Mercenaries. Stay down, Cooper.
BT, let's go!
We have 18 hours! 18 hours until the Ark is sealed and ready for delivery. Oi, Richter! Leave the corpses alone, you sick bastard. We've got a job to do, eh? We make corpses, we don't clean them up. Let's go!
Transfer authorization to new pilot, Link, Bravo Tango, 7274. Cooper, take my Titan. Use my helmet in my jump kit. This is the real thing. Take care of him.
There are quite some instances that the frame rate cap comes into play for this system. However, they are not many. The problem is that the higher end video cards will be maxing out the frame rate cap throughout the run. Hello, mate.
Pittsburgh Militia Grenadier Bay Militia Survivor.
Intruders, this is General Marder of the Interstellar Manufacturing Corporation. You're in violation of sovereign law. I'm offering you a brief amnesty. Surrender yourself to an IOC officer.
We work with whoever the IOC say we do.
What are you trying to get? Metal?
I don't care who's giving you orders. Blitz getting mercs, General Marder. Us grunts get paid the same either way. All that matters. That thing the mountains goes online is shitting.
You think it's true? What the techs are saying about it?
Do I have a fucking problem? If it is true...
Many militia forces in the region. We will find you. You are advised to discard any weapons and surrender immediately. Do not attempt to resist. Lethal force is authorized against any armed militia forces. extra personnel. I must remind you that you are on the planet Titan. This is an IMC-controlled planet. There are many wild creatures outside the bounds of our instance.
And this is the end of the benchmark. Indeed, a very beautiful game. Runs very nicely. 116 frames per second. Excellent performance. Good frame rate, good frame times. We do have some spike here and there. Let's see how this will affect the overall stats of the run. We do have reached the frame rate cap of 144 frames per second at some instances. However, the benchmark is still valid. We have a lot of frame rate which is below that, most of the frame rate actually. The GPU usage is maxing out, no problem whatsoever. The CPU usage on the other hand is quite light, quite low, so the game is quite light. As you can see, we are looking at 20 to 25% overall. This means good programming of the main code. CPU temps are fine. Very enjoyable game. 5.8 GB, 5.7 GB of system RAM usage. Not too heavy on the RAM either. The core clock of the video card was at 1987 for the most part. Okay, no problem. The video RAM seems to be increasing as the game progresses at 5.8 GB, maxing out. I hope this does not imply any memory leak. The CPU clock at 5 GHz. We saw that in game, of course. Maxed. Very good. I think I have quite a lot of data to show you guys in this run. First of all, let's focus on this system. Let's load this benchmark first. Okay, and now we can proceed to my two other runs of this game, which were also GPU limited, thankfully. I believe I have two runs here, indeed. The first one is from the 970 and the other one is from the 7950 with the i7-860 gain. Okay, let's make this a blue one and let's make this, yes, dark green. It is absolutely fine. So 116 frames per second for the 1070, 80 for the 970, a very good result. 66 for the 7950, again one more very good result. The game is very well made and very well optimized, so we are having very good performance for all runs on all systems. That's the kind of games. That's the kind of game I like benchmarking. So, for 60 milliseconds, zoomed out. I do not see this huge spike that MSI Afterburner recorded. Maybe the 3-frame limit discarded it, which is a good thing. I did not see it, to tell you the truth, while gaming. Very good performance, a little variability, stuttering not very much. Good performance overall. Let's remember quickly how the GTX 970 fared. Also a very good run with good frame times, not very much stuttering. Frame times above 16.7 milliseconds are only 0.1 percent, 8 frames, and just that. The GTX 970 also had a similar very good rating, indeed only 2% this time. And even the 7950 had a very good result, 19.30, not something to worry about. The histogram is excellent, of course, of the GTX 1070. Everything is even below 11 milliseconds. Crazy performance. Frame times at 7, 8, 9, and 10 milliseconds. Absolutely fantastic. A quick reminder of the 970. A little more scattering, as you can see, but still decent performance. Not too bad. The 7950 had a little higher stuttering, as is evident here. Now let's move to the frame times. The 7950 indeed had some huge spikes here, and also the run was longer. The 970 was also longer, and the 1070 was shorter. I have told you before, guys, that when gaming on this system and benchmarking this system, I have noticed that I am considerably better as a gamer, and this has a direct consequence that my runs most of the time end up shorter on the GTX 1070. However, this is besides the point. It's very clear that the frame times are way lower. In my own benchmarks, I have seen that even if the length is exactly the same, it has no significance really. All stats end up about the same. It is exactly the same path. It just happens on a shorter time period. So the same thing happens. The same things happen essentially. Nothing to worry about. The frame rate is evidently a lot better on the GTX 1070, of course. Min, max, and averages. Thankfully, this time we have very good readings from all systems. Not a huge difference from the 1070 to the 970. The 7950 is a little further behind. I will do some calculations in the next chart, which is the most informative in terms of frame rate. 49% faster for the 1070. A very good reading. The 7950 was quite good. As you can see, the 970 was only 21% faster. Nothing to worry about. The 1% lows are 42% higher for the 1070, and 41 for the 0.1% lows. Very good performance. We can see that the 0.1% lows are actually close to the GTX 970 average. But in this specific case, this does not matter too much, because we are looking at very good frame rates. Okay, the delta is what it is, but the frame rate and the gaming experience is very good for both these systems, for all three systems, to tell you the truth. I remember my 79 run was also very good. The newer system, of course, does show its teeth when you study stuttering and variability. It is a lot more faster and gives a smoother gaming experience compared to the other two. The percentiles curves, as you can see, much smoother for the 1070. The 970 is not too bad. The 7950 is a little more unstable, but still quite decent. We can see that the 16 millisecond threshold is around here. Okay, not too bad. I don't think this will help us a lot or at all. And to finish this video, we have the comparable, of course, meaning what the game feels like due to the variability and the stuttering. The 1070 was again 48% faster. However, what is important is that even the 970 managed to give an above 60 frames per second gaming experience at maxed settings, nonetheless. And the 7950 was also very respectable for its age, a 5-year-old card, giving a 51 frames per second average at max settings for this game. It means that this game is very well made, very well programmed, and kudos to the developers. I really like benchmarking this game. I hope you really like this video as well, my friends. Thank you very much for watching. See you later.